Dry eyes after Restylane treatment in under eye trough. I have extreme dry eyes owing to Hashimoto's disease. I consulted 3 plastic surgeons who said Restylane would not exacerbate my dry eye. When first performed, I swelled pretty badly, but experienced no change in my dry eye. 2 days after my procedure, my eyes are still swollen and slightly bruised, and so painfully dry I am incapacitated. I have always been hyperallergic. One reason I got Restylane was that I can't wear makeup near my eyes, and heard allergies from it were rare. Now I am really scared.
Thank you for your question. You state in your question that you have a history of severe dry eye due to Hashimoto's thyroiditis, and that you had, prior to undergoing Restylane injection in the tear trough area, consulted 3 plastic surgeons who stated that there would be no issue with the dry eye with the placement of Restylane in the tear trough. Further, in your history, you described that you had the injection performed and you had significant swelling, but you didn't have dry eye initially, but then 2 days later, you have considerable swelling and extreme dry eye symptoms, and you're just wanting to know what's going on and why, and that you're very concerned. Well, I could certainly assist you with this question. I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon and fellowship-trained oculofacial plastic and reconstructive surgeon. As an oculofacial plastic reconstructive surgeon, the fellowship training is in diseases and conditions affecting the eyelids, the orbit, and the lacrimal system, the tear duct, tear gland system. So I can certainly provide you with my perception from my experience in the treatment of lacrimal diseases. So there is certainly a lot of validity to the choice of going with Restylane to fill the tear trough area. Certainly, the hyaluronic acid fillers do not require any skin testing prior to treatment because of the low likelihood of an allergy to the filler. Back in the day before the Restylane or any other hyaluronic acid filler had come out, we were using Zyderm and Zyplast, and that was a bovine source, and therefore we need to do skin testing before using that as an injectable. Now, the tear trough is an anatomic area that has the word tear in it, but honestly, there is no actual direct relationship with the production of tears. Tears are produced by the lacrimal glands that are in the conjunctiva for your baseline tears, and then there is the lacrimal gland in the orbit for reactive tearing. And then deep in the bone, towards the nose in the tear trough, is the lacrimal duct. So then that's what drains your tears. So there may be some issue related to sensitivity to the injection process, and the fact that maybe, or I should say that there's a possibility that you may have a sensitivity to Restylane, because in the absence of a photo, it's hard to tell how swollen you are. You know, because when someone describes swelling, it's very subjective. Now, with that being said, the management of your dry eye, I'm sure you're already familiar with. You have to be very aggressive with topical lubricants, and make sure that you use something like an ointment or a gel at night to lubricate the eye when sleeping. It's very tricky when it comes to the autoimmune diseases to predict how someone is going to respond. I have treated patients with your condition as well as lupus and a variety of other diseases that are in the autoimmune spectrum, and certainly there is going to be individual variability. Now, a solution for you might be, just for peace of mind, is to dissolve the filler. That might be a way to, at least for you, to not to know that there is no more filler in that area. You know, it's interesting, the tear trough area is very challenging sometimes. We, in our practice, we combine the use of hyaluronic acid filler like Restylane with platelet-rich plasma to improve skin quality and to improve the color of the skin and to improve the longevity of the filler at the same time. That's been something that we've observed. I sometimes, because I also use PRP or platelet-rich plasma for people with acne scars and people who have had inflammation and actual active inflammation, and I've seen benefit with that, I would even wonder whether there may have been some value in considering combining PRP with the filler in this area. But this is not something you do immediately. This is something in a clinical relationship you do as part of an ongoing relationship to see if something works. You know, that's the art of medicine, the art of patient care in an ongoing long-term basis rather than in an episodic basis, which unfortunately with the commoditization tendencies of various types of fillers and injectables, people sometimes do. I'm not saying that's your case at all. Your doctor may also want to just try putting you on some type of anti-inflammatory, like a steroid or something like that, to try to reduce the inflammation. This might be reflective of other systemic inflammations occurring, but if it's the area is very red or very itchy or basically inflamed from the placement of the filler, then dissolution might be the best option for you. Meet with your doctor again. Talk about your concerns. Don't let this don't wait to go see your doctor. I tell my patients I'm available to them 24 hours a day as a surgeon, and for even my filler patients or my hair loss patients, they can always reach me. And I always want patients to come in with any questions or concerns. And I think most doctors share the same philosophy who really have a practice that's similar to my own. So I think that, again, meeting with your doctor, asking about dissolving the filler, asking about anti-inflammatories to help with managing the inflammation, and of course, aggressive eye lubrication. What I can at least probably help you understand is that the injectable filler is not likely to have caused the eyes to become very dry directly. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck, and thank you for your question.